Okay, so welcome to course NMR spectroscopy for chemists and biologists. This course we have tuned for level of graduate students, so therefore we can name it as graduate course on NMR spectroscopy for chemists and biologists. I, Professor Ashutosh Kumar, together with Professor R.V. Hosur, will be taking this course. So this is a full semester course. Now if you look at the tree of knowledge of science, at the bottom of this in the root it is a physics, then branches are chemistry, so there is more complexity as we move from physics to chemistry, and then when we move to biology even more complex phenomena happens, and in the medicine it is quite complicated science, so complexity increases. Now fortunately NMR is one such tool which can connect all the way from physics, chemistry, biology and medicine, so therefore it is very suitable for all branches of science. Now if you look at the development of NMR, or we call it NMR evolution, actually Block and Purcell from the USA discovered this phenomena of nuclear moment and they got the Nobel Prize in 1952. Now Jean Jenner, actually he discovered or he proposed the idea of two-dimensional NMR, which was implemented by Professor Richard Ernst. Richard Ernst is credited for Fourier transform NMR and he got the Nobel Prize in 1991. It was Professor Kurt Uhtrich who brought NMR from chemistry to biology, and he actually demonstrated its application in structural biology, therefore he was awarded Nobel Prize in 2002. At Bex he developed several three-dimensional NMR experiment and he expanded NMR into a structural biology for looking at the biological macromolecular structure and dynamics. Now in medicine it was Paul Lutterberger and Peter Mansfield who brought NMR in MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, and they got Nobel Prize in 2002. So if you look at in physics, it was mostly the looking at the absorption line and looking at the nuclear property of various spins. Then in chemistry, various two-dimensional and three-dimensional spectrum were recorded to get the structure of the molecules, and then in medicine it is the brain image that is recorded and that encompasses from physics all the way to medicine. Now where we can use NMR, all the way from structural biology where we can record various experiment to look at the structure and dynamics of macromolecule. We can use NMR in variety of materials where we can look at the detailed property of these materials, and we can use NMR in biologics and drug discovery. So therefore in today's research world, NMR is one of the prominent tool in all field of science. This course is for 12 weeks. So we will be starting with basic concepts of nuclear spins and its property and sensitivity. Then we move forward to explain selection rule and Block equation. In third week we will go to high resolution spectrum of small molecules. Then we deal with chemical shift, spin coupling, and we give many examples to do analysis of a spectrum. Then we move to Fourier transform NMR and its practical aspects. Now in seventh week we go to advanced concept like polarization transfer and solvent suppression, which is used for protein structure determination. In eighth week we will be dealing with multipulse experiment and relaxation measurement, and then in ninth week we will develop the quantum mechanical concept using density matrix description of NMR. In 10th week we will be dealing with multidimensional NMR spectroscopy, and further in 11th week we will be dealing with various type of 2D experiment that can be used for protein and peptide structure determination. So we will conclude with how to determine the protein structure or peptide structure using NMR spectroscopy. Thank you, looking for your active participation.